A victim mentality is very different from being a real victim. A real victim is a survivor. They're usually a survivor of an assault, some kind of trauma, something that happened to them growing up, an accident, unbelievable things. But a victim mentality is when you haven't had any type of situation to victimize you, but rather you've taken on the mentality of blaming others for your situation, especially the situations that don't go well. So in other words, if you grow up with a victim mentality, it means you've had a terrible time, a very difficult time, accepting any criticism as your responsibility. You never saw what you could do to make it different, and you never had to. Usually victim mentality children are raised by at least one victim mentality parent. They're modeled, and so when those children learn that time and time again, or maybe one of the parents didn't have it, but maybe one of their parents had it, for whatever reason, the child is enabled. They're basically pampered, they're taken care of. And whenever anything happens that should be their responsibility, there should be a natural consequence, the parents jump in and save them. So they never had to really take responsibility for any decision or situation they caused or chose in life. And they grow up blaming others. These people are out there and they're dating other people who oftentimes they'll get in a relationship with somebody who really likes to help. And that helper will become the main person that's taking care of this person with a victim mentality. If you're an enabler of one of these people and you're in a relationship with them, you're not doing them any favors by taking care of them. Basically, the only way to get over this is to be confronted with what's going on. But I want to give you some scenarios so you know exactly what it is, because many times you're with someone and you're like, yeah, they blame somebody else. They can never take responsibility. That may be a once in a lifetime or a once or twice occurrence you've seen, but it's not consistent. People who have a victim mentality, oh, they're consistent with it, like everything. So the first thing is they love to talk about how they were harmed in another relationship, and they never see themselves as being part of that. Like, they can't own anything they did wrong. It was all done to them. They blame their ex, they blame their exes, they blame anybody in the relationship. And when something comes up that, you know, what did you do then? What did you choose? It was always, they didn't get to choose. Somebody else did this and then that botched it for them or whatever. Next, they can't talk about any situation they've been in where they've been able to make a change. So in other words, whether it's work, whether it's with a family member, whether it's with friends, there's never a problem that happens where they can clearly see, well, I could have chosen this. If you were to ask this person, I want you to list three things that you could have done different, they will give you a reason or an excuse why that wouldn't have worked and why they couldn't choose anything. They also get upset easily about minor issues in relationships. Maybe you've noticed some little thing will happen in your relationship and they go off. It's like they can't take anything that's off the plan or off the course or off the routine. They do not change easily, and they basically are looking for who's at fault for changing the schedule or the situation, and that's a person they're going to focus on blaming. They have a very real sense of insecurity and instability about the relationship. You guys might be committed, you might be planning an engagement, and still, they're just not sure. They're finding little things that could go wrong because they're very pessimistic, because they can't accept responsibility. So if you think about it, if you didn't believe in yourself that you could change a course of action and everything was done to you, you may better be able to understand why they feel this way, why they're so threatened and insecure that something good could possibly even come. They also hold grudges. They will never forget anything that happens that was against them, whether it's the first grade, the second grade, kindergarten, Oh, they remember. And it basically goes back to when they started, what kind of things, situations happened that formulated this mindset for them at a very young age to still be with them now as an adult. I think it's important too that you remember drama is part of their persona. They like drama. They like causing big problems because if they can make the problem so much bigger, you can see how this was done to them. It helps them project the blame because look what they caused. And basically what they caused was a small thing until they made it bigger. Now you may think, am I one of these people? Am I dating one of these people? Because honestly, I see them, I have them in as clients many times. I think it's important that you kind of go through this list. First of all, if it's you, it's important that you start like jotting down, these are situations. Yeah, this does relate to how I was raised. Yeah, I do have a hard time taking responsibility. But if you find you're dating this kind of person, and if this is you, then I for sure would encourage you to get help, get online. There's a lot of good online therapy that you can do or work with a coach to kind of step up your game, start taking more responsibility. But if this is your partner, what you want to do is you want to liken it to a time. They do the best with this. If you don't confront them directly, but say, you know, I used to feel this way, and then go back to what you did. You know, I used to feel this way. I always was looking at for whoever else was blamed. And then one day I just got sick of it because when you blame others, you can't change it. And I wanted to change it going forward. So that's when I started thinking, identifying three little actions I could do that would change my mind about it. And I would also encourage them and talk to them about positive psychology, because what we do know with the victim mentality is positive psychology really does. I want you to list positive things that could have come about from this rather than jumping on the negative train. When you do this with adults, they really respond to it. Probably they would respond when they were a little child too, but it's very important that you don't insinuate any blame on them. Just so it always works better if you say, you know, I was thinking, or I felt this way one time, and then I started thinking, you know, there's gotta be some positives from this. Why am I always looking at the negative? And I started just reiterating in my mind the positive things that could have come about from this if I had chosen them. And lastly, I think it's important that you really are honest with yourself. Do you wanna be with this person? If you really love this person, but they have this terrible victim mentality and you think that you think you can heal with them or they can heal from watching you, your mentoring, then it's one thing. But if they have this from birth and other friends have noticed this about them and you find that you're dating them, but they're, you know, they're always on the negative side of stuff and it makes you start seeing less joy, you don't feel as happy, you feel like you're carrying all the burden, the emotional and the physical care in this relationship, you may wanna ask yourself, do I really wanna be with this person? Because I think it's different if you're married to this person, but if you're dating this person and they can't start to kind of come to terms with it or grow through it, then you're marrying someone in a stuck mindset that most likely will not change. It will only get worse if you continue living your life and helping pick up on their side. And it's very hard to separate that when you're committed in a long-term relationship. Then I think it might be a good idea for you to evaluate and then let go of this. Because many times people who were raised in this kind of an environment, they hang on to this and they don't just get over it. They don't just flip to the positive side. And that's really not a fair thing for you to sign up to if you're not married to the person yet. So once again, if this video is helpful for you, please push the button and subscribe. If you're already a subscriber, thank you so much.